Hulk Hogan, the earthquake said he was gonna get you, and he got you. The earthquake said he was gonna hurt you, and he hurt you. The earthquake said he was gonna put you out of wrestling, and you're out!
Hulk Hogan is gone forever! Hulkamania is dead, and you can thank me for it!
I just left the Hulkster, you know, and seen him lying in that bed, all busted up. Man, something I've never, ever seen in my entire life. I've never seen a Hulkster like this. You know, and I looked up and looked into his eyes, and that look of anguish, that look of sadness, you know. It wasn't from the physical pain, you know. It was here in his heart and in his head. He feels like he's let us down. Well, you Hulksters out there, man, you know darn well, and I know darn well, that the Hulksters never let down a person in his life. Whenever any of us needed him, the Hulk's always been there. You felt the charisma, you felt the warmth, you felt the electricity, the Hulkamania. He's always been there. Well, now's the time for us to give back to him what he's given to us all these years. That warmth, that love, that charisma, give it back to him. Put the smile back on his face. Let him know. I'm asking you, please. Let the man know how you feel about him. Let him know that you care.
Now this is going to be something.
Finally, these two, the ring, one-on-one. From the Soviet Union, weighing 296 pounds, Boris Super.
That's a big man in there, 296. Although Nikolai
Ladies
must be up around that mark as well.
Mr. Zukov requests that you all rise and respect this singing of the Soviet National Anthem.
Oh, I can't sit down. Will you please?
Hey, Gorbachev's on his way. I like him.
Boris can't sing at all. Mars is a little bit better.
And his opponent, making his way to the ring,
for a tag team partners,
weighing 313 pounds.
There will no longer be partners after this. Anybody can sing better than Mars. Now you'll like it, I suppose, right? You know what they do to traitors, goes to McMahon.
Nikolai Volkov, singing the American National Anthem. I love it.
Oh, my goodness. You got a rocket's red glare right there. Zukov all over his former tag team partner, Nikolai.
When you got two Russians in the ring.
Ooh, no. Nikolai is being hammered from pillar to post. And that's exactly what should happen to a traitor.
Ooh, no.
Shoulder first into the ring post. Do you concur? Having no mercy whatsoever. Do you concur with that?
I don't concur with that at all.
That's exactly what a traitor should get.
What's he going to do now?
Going to give him a boot, it looks like. Literally. Boris nails his former partner, Nikolai. Roll call on the receiving end here. Boris has gone nuts.
You know, this is unique because that's a wrestling boot, so it's not an illegal object, McMahon. What type of ruling would you get there?
Obviously, it's illegal and it's just.
How do you figure? It's part of his wardrobe.
I figure Boris Zukov had no reason to attack Nikolai from behind. I don't know whether he was more upset with Nikolai opposing him or more upset with the fact that Nikolai was singing the national anthem. Nikolai, what's he doing? Nikolai's going after Boris. The big 300-pounder is hot on the tail of Boris Zukov.
are going back to the dressing room.
Flowers for real.
You think Brother Love's for real?
I'll tell you who's for real right here.
Yeah, you got a point there. The only man to have defeated the Ultimate Warrior for a championship.
It is a pleasure to have you here. Brother Love, you made a mistake. A big mistake. From now on, he is to be introduced as the next World Wrestling Federation champion.
I'm so sorry, Brother Bray. That is my mistake. But please allow me to do the honor and introduce to you the next WWF champion, Ravishing Rick Rude.
You know, Warrior, you may have shown the rest of the world that you're worthy of being called World Wrestling Federation Champion. But you see, you've got to prove it to me. And that's not going to be so easy, Warrior, because I can be Ravishing or I can be Rude. You see, Warrior, I have the ability to make some people feel real good. And I have the ability to make some people feel real bad.
You know, Brother Love, I want all the people to understand.
Yeah, I gotta say, the guy looks great.
Talk about feeling real bad. There will be no more Rude Awakening until this man defeats and becomes the World Wrestling Federation champion.
You mean no more?
I'm going to make it simple. Read my list. There will be no more Rude Awakening until this man, Ravishing Rick Rude, becomes the World Wrestling Federation champion.
So there you have it, Warrior. I've shown you mine. Now you show me yours. When you come to show me, make sure you bring the World Wrestling Federation title belt with you, because that's what I want, and that's what I'm going to have. Don't you just hate that?
And you could very well have it. What a matchup that would be. Ravishing Rick Rude against the Ultimate Warrior.
Here's something that really opens up my baby's carburetor. Come on, baby. Arrogant. Yes, the man's cologne that primes pistons. Yes, that makes spark plugs grow hotter and that improves your engine's performance. I love it. And now, put the brakes on the mundane and accelerate into the fast lane with arrogance.
Join me in welcoming, along with his manager, Bobby the Brain Heenan, Ravishing Rick Rude.
Well, no wonder he walked out. Forgot that he had to do this interview. You got the right idea, young lady.
I didn't like that introduction, Okerlund.
What do you...
Obviously want something special. I like his new haircut.
I don't know if I can do that.
You can do it, believe me.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have been told to introduce this man as the next World Wrestling Federation champion, Ravishing Rick Rude.
You know, Okerlund, there's a time to be ravishing, and there is a time to be rude. Tell him what I mean, Bobby.
from this point on until this man here becomes the new World Wrestling Federation champion, there will be no more rude awakening.
I assume he means the one after
the match. You better expound on that, Bobby. What do you mean?
It's simple. Until this man, Ravishing Rick Rude here, defeats the Ultimate Warrior and becomes the next World Wrestling Federation champion, there will be no more rude awakenings. Now, ladies, you're going to have to understand something. You're going to have to find a hobby. You're going to have to bear with it for a while. You're going to have to go cold turkey. But remember this, it won't be for long. Let's reverse roles for just a minute, Okerlund. Let me ask you a question. Who is the only man to ever defeat the Ultimate Warrior? Come on, spit it out, Okerlund.
You!
So, who am I?
Well, you're Rick Rude, of course.
Who am I, Okerlund?
You're the next World Wrestling Federation champion, Ravishing Rick Rude.
That's right.
You know, last week I asked all you Hulkamaniacs out there to show the Hulkster how you really care about him. And a lot of you did. But then again, a lot of you didn't. You know, maybe you didn't hear me. Maybe you didn't understand me. Or maybe you just don't realize how important this whole situation is. You know, I just came from being with the Hulkster, and he's in the... like I've never seen him before. You know, he's down, man. He's ready to give this up. He's ready to throw it all away. The end of Hulkamania. We can't let this happen. You know, last week, I asked you, please show the man how much you care about him. I'm not asking you, please, this week. I'm begging you.
Coming down the aisle.
I didn't know you were a snake lover, McMahon.
Well, not really. I mean, personally, I'm not too fond of snakes. They're going to give me the willies, you know. But I look forward to him wrestling. He's one of the best wrestlers in the World Wrestling Federation today. And if you're Todd Burton, what are you thinking about, Jeff?
You're thinking about trying to score an upset win. That's what you're thinking about. That's what everybody thinks about when they step in the ring, McMahon, winning.
I see. What's Bad News Brown thinking about?
Probably snakes, as I understand it.
Right. He gets real wide-eyed, too, when he thinks about them. Especially big ones like Damien.
And off to roll. Jake to stick. Shorter block, and Burton Rudder doesn't move too well. What happens here? Oh. Oop. Catches him with a left. Series of left jabs. Now Jake off and a right hand clipped him across the jaw.
Whoa, the right hand took him down. Burton, a pretty tough customer, but Jake eventually gets him down.
Nice knee lift.
You know, McMahon, on newsstands this Tuesday, the new WWF magazine with none other than the one and only, the Macho King, Randy Savage, on the cover. Terrific cover. And inside, page 52, dire predictions. Bad News Brown and Jake the Snake.
On occasion, Jake will reach for the bag, which he has been warned several times now by the official. Jake the Snake, the Hammerlock. Now to the arm bar. Burton back to his feet. Let's see what he can do. A hair pull by Burton. Burton, here's his shoulder blocks now. Get in there, Raph. Burton to the midsection. Burton winding up. Jake out in front. Reversal. Oh,
whoa, did he catch him with that short clothesline? And you know what that's generally a setup for?
Yeah.
Look at, even the fans know what they're chanting for.
They want to see the DDT. I want to see it. Jake with Burton. Switches Burton. The three count.
And that music starts. And now Jake will make a beeline.
Wait a minute. Bad News Brown out of nowhere. Look out from behind. Bad News Brown attacking. Jake the Snake Roberts. He has no business being in there.
Got him with a shot to the throat, McMahon.
Bad News Brown out of nowhere.
No, he's out of Harlem.
Bad News now. Missing with that. Jake trying to escape from Bad News. There is no escape. Once this man attacks you, you've had it. If he gains the advantage, he's going to keep it.
And he's got the advantage now. What he needs to do is get around Danny Davis and keep it up.
Yeah, but this is not a match. This is uncalled for here. This is a blatant attack from behind by Bad News Brown, the headbutt. Jake knocked all the way to the outside.
Bad News is going to open that bag up, McMahon.
Bad News is going to go after Damien.
What a gutsy move on the part of Bad News. Look at the guts of this guy.
He's trying to overcome his fear. It's this. Snatching the bag.
It's tied up, huh?
Yeah, it's tied up, all right. The Snake can't get out of the bag. All of a sudden now, Bad News Brown has a lot of guts. What's he going to do?
He's going to put the Snake on Jake for a chair.
Kick in the back of the head. He's going to hit Jake with a chair.
Oh, wait a minute. He's going to hit Damien with a chair.
No, he's not. Oh, come on. Bad News Brown now. The Snake can't get out. He can't run. He can't protect himself. Bad News Brown now. The chair is going to jam it down into the Snake. The Snake's tied up. Bad News Brown with a chair.
This could end Damien.
For all, McMahon. And Jake trying to come in.
No more Snake abuse.
You gotta get in there. Jake makes a run. He just saves Damien and Nick Akon.
Well, isn't this a change of pace? Jake saving Damien.
Hey, look. Damien's out of the bag. Give it to him, Jake. Give it to him. Oh, look. Look, Bad News is trapped. Bad News runs for cover. Bad News is running for cover.
He's got a phobia, McMahon. Why don't you have a little sympathy for him?
Sympathy? Get him, Jake. Get him. Bad News is running. He's running. Bad News is running all the way up on the crowd.
What a chicken.
How yellow can you get? Bad News Brown after the attack on Jake the Snake from behind. And then from there, he was going to do Damien in. He was going to drive that chair down into Damien and do him in. But thank goodness, it's this man prevailing. And not only is he prevailing now.
Oh, I can't wait. Look at the fear on the face of Bad News Brown.
Yeah, I know. I'll agree with her. We are up in there.
Jesse. Hey, I'm listening to Brother Love. I don't interrupt people when they're talking, McMahon.
Their mother country, a traitor of sorts. eliminated. What's going on? Like I'm going to do that no good traitor, Nikolai Volkov.
Well, you know, Brother Morris, Nikolai Volkov has already adopted American customs, American habits. Well, he is even singing the American national anthem. America has opened their arms and their hearts to Nikolai Volkov.
Yeah, and I hate the U.S. of A. I cannot break the law. What I hate more than anything else, that is that no good Nikolai Volkov. And when I get him into the ring, I will prove to him and the world once and for all that might is right.
It may be, but it may not be his. Ted DiBiase.
What we have here is a failure to communicate. Because what's been communicated to me thus far about the big boss man is what a fair and honest man he was, what a just prison guard he was at the Cobb County Correctional Institute. Well, I'm here in Cobb County today to tell you people that that was all a bunch of bunk. Because I have a man right here that tells a totally different story. Hey! Did you ever spend any time in jail?
Yes, Cobb County Correctional Institute.
The Cobb County Correctional Institute. And while you were at the Cobb County Correctional Institute, did you know a man they call the Big Boss Man?
Yes.
It's okay. Don't be scared. Don't be scared. You knew the Big Boss Man. Well, tell me, was he a fair and honest man? Was
no.
he a just man?
No.
No, it's okay. Don't be scared. I'll take care of you. Listen, he wasn't fair. He wasn't honest. Well, then tell me. How did he treat you?
He used to come in at night and handcuff me and beat me.
And beat you. How long did he beat you?
All night.
Beat you all night long.
All
so what
night.
You're telling me is that he treated you like a dog.
No, nobody treats a dog like that.
Nobody treats a dog like that. That's what I've been saying all along. This is an example of a big boss man's justice. A man reduced to shoveling dirt. And that boss man is just what you are, a great big...
Back now to Cobb County, Georgia. Well, this appears to be the same pile of sand where the million-dollar man Ted DiBiase was talking to the former prison inmate from Cobb County Correctional Institute regarding the big boss man. So many contradictions in the testimony, I'd like to talk to that same individual and get some answers for myself. Oh, excuse me, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, I'm very curious. The million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase, was here recently talking to a man who was shoveling sand over in that pile.
Shoveling sand? No, I haven't had anybody out there shoveling.
Well, this man happened to be a former prisoner over at the Cobb County Correctional Institution.
No, I'm the only former inmate who works here.
And your position here, sir?
I'm foreman.
Foreman?
Yes.
Very impressive. Do you know the big boss man?
Big boss man, yes, ma'am. Yes, sir.
I'm very curious. Did he ever hit you? Did he ever beat you?
Beat me? No, boss man wouldn't beat anybody.
Well, what kind of a human being did you find the big boss man to be?
A very fine man. In fact, if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't have his job here.
Very enlightening, sir. I thank you very much.
Yes, sir.
You know, this seems to be a stellar example of big boss man justice here in Cobb County. And not just another con job on the part of the million-dollar man.
Still, case of manpower. How could you possibly be laughing?
I'll tell you why, baby. I want to read you a few cards and letters that have come into the Earthquake Epicenter, Mean Gene. Take this one. It goes, "Hi, Earthquake. I'm 12 years old. It is great not to have to look at that overweight, out of shape, big, big ton of blubber Hulk Hogan anymore."
Wait a minute. What? What? You've got more?
Oh, wait a minute.
He wrote that
himself.
This is my
favorite letter, baby. I like this. "I'm glad you put Hulk Hogan out of wrestling, and I hope he stays out. P.S. We love you, Earthquake."
Wait a minute. Where did you get this correspondence, this letter? What about an earthquake?
When I came to the WWF, I wanted to meet the top wrestler in the World Wrestling Federation, and that was Hulk Hogan. When I caused Hulk Hogan to lose the World Wrestling Championship in WrestleMania 6, There was only one more thing that I wanted from him, and that was his career.
You did it.
On the Brother Love Show, I delivered 3 earthquakes. I registered 10 on the Richter scale.
Navrata love it. Arrogance for men will make you the number one seed. One shot, and you'll be in the royal box. I don't know that.
You know, there's a big, big letter writing campaign going on for the return of Hulk Hogan. But you see, kids, it's not going to work. You're wasting your time because you see Hulk Hogan, his ribs are crushed. He even has to have somebody to read the letters to him. So it's not going to work. You can forget it.
Hulk Hogan won't be back for 2 reasons. The first one is because nobody can survive the earthquakes that I put on him. And the second reason is because he knows if he comes back, he has to face me. And I said it before and I'll say it again. Hulkamania is dead. And it's going to stay that way.
Hey, I know all you little Hulksters out there are wondering what kind of guy I am. You know, I come out here 2 weeks ago and I asked all you, please let the Hulkster know how much you care for him. Last week I come out here and I asked, I begged. That's right. I got down and begged. And well, let me tell you something. I'm not too proud to beg as long as it's for the right reason. And Hulkamania is definitely the right reason. You know, every time I'm with the Hulkster and he's reading one of your cards or letters,
I could see it's having a positive effect on him. I could just see it in his eyes. And he reads them over and over and over again. You know, just the other day, just for a second, I caught a gleam of light in his eye. You know what it was? It was the eye of the Hulkster, man. It's incredible. You're definitely having a positive effect on him. So keep those cards and letters coming, because we can both do it together. Yeah.
Here we go again.
At this time, yeah. I think it would be appropriate that each and every one of you rise to your feet and bow in servitude to my guest, the Macho King, Randy Savage, and the sensational wig, Sherry. Oh, yeah.
There is the Macho King in all his glory. And I love that sensational queen. Purple jacket. Gorgeous.
Thank you.
The secret of my success. Before every matchup, I pump up with this. Arrogance. It's today's man in a classic can. The fragrance that overwhelms, and pins down the competition. It's arrogance for man. Until we meet.
WF superstars of wrestling ice cream bars are made for royalty like myself, not for the peasants like Sapphire.
My guest this week, take the Saint Roberts.
Boy, it's a good thing that he didn't hit Damien with that steel chair.
Good thing for Damien.
He would want to seal the casket on his career.
See, news is very precise. He likes to take his time.
Well, Jake Roberts, usually I see you out here with the sink in the bag. What's going on?
Well, I found out last week that you need somebody to watch your back at all times.
Speaking of that, last week on the Superstars of Wrestling, in front of a national television audience, after you had given your opponent the DDT, guess what? Bad News Brown from behind.
He cheated me? And he cheated Damien, you see. Damien gets rewarded each and every time I use the DDT. Now, Bad News Brown, you tell me how tough you are. Well, brother, a tough man does not jump somebody from behind. He walks up to their face and says, here, take this. Now, that's what I'm telling you. Bad news to me, you're just sad news.
You know, I've got to point out, Jake Roberts, that Bad News Brown suffers from a very serious case of ophidiophobia. He's afraid of snakes. I think I am.
Now, would I be the kind of guy that would exploit someone's weakness or a fear?
Not Jake.
Would I do that, I ask you? Would I?
I think you would, Jake.
Of course I would. I'll tell you something, sad news. Here's the bottom line. I am like a window too dark to see through. A mystery in my ways and my habits. The kind of man you'll never understand because you've never been that kind of man.
And let that be a lesson to you.
Damien looked great. I guess he's all local, huh?
Well, 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 here I am. I've come down here to the deep south, to the very roots of the big boss man, to this despicable place he calls home, Cobb County, Georgia, to expose him for what he really is. And who do I have standing next to me? None other than one of his old high school teachers, Miss Cofer. Now, Miss Cofer, let me ask you a few questions about the boss man. Tell me, what kind of a student was he? Was he an intelligent boy?
No. I've been teaching for 20 years, and he's probably the worst student I've ever had.
Worst student you've ever had. Well, what kind of grades did he make?
F's. All F's.
No B's, no C's.
No. In fact, he was so bad, we kept him in the dunce corner most of the time. We've renamed it now. Big Boss Man Corner.
Big Boss Man Corner. Well, was he at least an honest child?
No, he had to cheat to make the F's he made.
And lie?
Oh, yes.
So what you're telling me, Miss Cofer, is that he cheated and he lied, and he still couldn't make the grade.
You got that.
So you see, boss man, from the mouth of one of your own teachers right here in Cobb County, Georgia, I've proven what I've said all along. You're nothing but a big, dumb, illiterate hick from Cobb County, Georgia. And just like the rest of the hicks from Cobb County, you, boss man, have a price for the million-dollar man. But you're too stupid to realize it.
All right, on their way to the ring now, tag team combination. The reign supreme among the World Wrestling Federation, the champion.
What's this? What is that? Looks like 1, 2, 3. What is going on? There are 3 members of Demolition? Is this the so-called surprise you alluded to earlier, Jesse?
Well, there you see Axe, there you see Smash, and guess who the third one is?
Have no idea. What do you know about it?
Crush. Push, Axe, Smash, and Crush.
Uh-huh.
There's 3 Demolition.
There's Axe on the left. That must be Crush there in the background.
No, that's him in the middle.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Well, why three members of Demolition, Jesse?
It's a bit different, isn't it? Now,
how do you know which three you're going to face, McMahon? Think about that.
Hopefully it won't be three. You mean which two?
Two out of the three. Three show up at the ring. Who's to say which ones are supposed to be in there? I'm a bit confused on that.
We remind you, great fans in the Manchester, New Hampshire area, again, 1 week from this Monday night on July 2nd, the WWF is back at the JFK Coliseum. Other stars coming to town will be Hillbilly Jim, Tito Santana. Also on the bill, the Orient Express, in addition to the Big Boss Man. Monday night, July 2nd, 1 week from this Monday, for World Wrestling Federation action at the John F. Kennedy Coliseum in Manchester, New Hampshire.
Wow, look at that. Diamond is no slouch when it comes to wrestling.
No slouch when it comes to the strength department. He caught Diamond in midair.
Punish him.
Punish him.
Punish him.
And Crush tagging in. Smash. He goes to work on Paul Diamond. Double team effort. Way up and off the... Ooh, down to the canvas. Look at this. Smash just hammering away...
Oh, what's going on here?
Attacks outside the ring.
There's three of them.
We're told the Hart Foundation is standing by. Perhaps we can get a word with them. Gentlemen, can you tell us? It seems to me the odds have shifted a little bit. Not so much in your favor with three members of Demolition.
Odds? 3-on-2? It's not one Demolition. It's not two Demolition. There's three. That's all the odds.
What I want to know is which two of the Demolition are going to defend the belts. That does pose a bit of a problem for the Hart Foundation. However, this isn't the first time the Hart Foundation will triumph over adversity. We are going to win our belts back against all odds. Yeah.
Jeez, Jesse, I don't know. If I were a member of the Hart Foundation, I would be a little upset over now three members of Demolition.
You know what I don't understand, though, McMahon, again?
What?
Ooh.
Belly-to-belly suplex.
There's only two belts.
Yeah?
And there's three Demolition. Who wears the belts, Axe and Smash?
Certainly you're the original members of Demolition. I don't know, Jesse.
We're going to have to get a ruling from that imbecile Tunney, aren't we?
You owe him an apology.
No,
you don't tell him a president of the World Wrestling Federation like that.
No telling what kind of ruling he's going to come out with, but there's definitely a problem here. I mean, Axe and Smash are the champions. Now you got Crush.
Well, would Crush be considered part of the championship team?
Your guess is as good as mine. Better get a Tunney ruling.
You can bet that the Hearts are going to sort it out, and that is Crush. And over the elbow.
Wham, and did you see that?
Right into the cover, and the three count.
Axe gave him the signal.
You're going to pay for it.
The winner of this bout, the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions.
I know, Jesse, to me, I think this is a little unfair now. You have three members of Demolition.
And woe's for you to think it's unfair. Look at that beautiful knee off the top rope by Crush. Belly-to-belly suplex, textbook style done right there. And they haven't lost a thing, no matter what Demolition's in there. Crush coming down with the big elbow while Smash holds him, and there they are. All three beautiful faces, McMahon. Let's go to the event center.
I'm really looking forward to this brother love, Jesse. This could be the ultimate brother love.
I always look forward to brother love.
This week is a man who I would least likely choose to be a guest here on the Brother Love Show. As a matter of fact, of all the guests that I have to choose from, would be the last. So I do so under duress.
Rude, you presented a challenge to me a long time ago. The battlefields where we had combat still have the fresh dirt that was overturned then. Now, Ravishing Rick Rude, you promised to bring greater strengths and greater challenges as my lord. Command me to tear the scar tissue for the wounds long ago. The poison will flow again, and the greater strength that you have will leave me and my warriors at even more of an ultimate power! You, brother, love, know about love. If it was not for the love these warriors have for me, I would not be standing here right now as the world champion. Do you think, as I go to the ring to do combat, it is the only time I have the full-blown intensity of a warrior? Can you not, brother love, feel the love the warriors have for me right now? I can hardly breathe. Whether the warriors come in big or small packages. I saw a small warrior around here earlier. Where is she? Where is she? This brother love is what love is all about. What's your name?
Amanda Ultimate Warrior.
Did you hear that? Amanda Ultimate Warrior. Because see, brother love, to understand the intensity of the love the warriors and I have for one another, you have to understand the strengths and the powers that we possess. For the biggest muscle I have is the heart that pumps in love. You little warriors. This little warrior, like all my other little warriors, has muscle. Show him your muscle, Amanda. Show him. Yeah. Like all my other little ultimate warriors, she has other talents. Show them apart with me. Show them apart. Awesome. Do a handstand for the ultimate warrior. Do a handstand for the ultimate warrior. This brother love right here is what intensity and love is all about. I love you, Amanda Ultimate Warrior. This is ultimate love.
A World Wrestling Federation champion, the Ultimate Warrior!
Hey, I got a letter I want to read to you. It's from a Hulkamaniac, just like you guys and me. But it's from a doctor. It's the says here, dear Hulk, it was very distressing to watch the earthquake ambush you on the Brother Love Show. As a physician, I realize all too well that your injuries must be causing you incredible pain. But please, Hulk, understand that Hulkamania always has and always will stand for everything that's right in the world. And it shall forever remain a tremendous source of courage and inspiration for me, my children, and everyone else. Best wishes for a speedy recovery. Dr. Mark Newberg. Wow, this is inspiration. Your letters are inspiration to Hulk Hogan. So let's inspire him like he's always inspired us. Let's show Hulk Hogan that we all really care.
You know, Hulkster, as the number one Stark Raven Hulkamaniac, I can speak for all the little Hulksters out there when I say that we all miss you, that we all love you, and that we all know that a heart like yours will never be stopped, that you will be back soon, and that Hulkamania will live forever!
It's no secret here in the World Wrestling Federation that the Hulk's been put down. But the Rockers know, and you know, he may be down, but he's never out.
That's right. You know it's one thing to put the Hulkster down, but it's a whole nother ball game to keep him down. And with the Rockers and all his Hulkamaniacs behind him, I know he can make it back.
Woo!
But I'm your amigo Hulk. Millions of fans of wearing one of this as a symbol for you to fight like you've never fought before because we want you back. Arriba!
Ho! Hulkster! You've done it before, and you can do it again. If anybody can come back from the earthquake, it's you, tough guy. Because remember, Hulk rules. Ho!
Coming for the Hulkster, the return of the World Wrestling Federation. I understand that those physical injuries are healing up very well, but mentally, he's not coming around yet.
Well, physically, you can always get better. Once you have that mental damage done to you by earthquake, you are finished, pal.
And there's the two culprits that set it all up. The ambush on the Hulkster. The Colonel of the Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart. You can bet that he was behind it all, Grant.
You notice Tugboat reading that letter from Dr. Newberg?
Yes.
Says, dear Hulk, it's obvious Tugboat's stealing the guy's mail.
Will you stop?
Boy, this whole podium here is shaking.
Devastation personified here in the form of earthquake.
He's a big man.
He's hovering around 500.
A pretty heavy hover.
And he's got quickness and balance, which makes him that much more dangerous.
When you wrestled and were 400 and some pounds, were you that quick?
I might have been a little bit quicker, Brain.
Why don't you show me how quick you are and leave?
Sure, you'd be lost out here, Brain. Guaranteed, though, here's a guy that's never lost anywhere. Mean Gene Okerlund wandering around this multitude here in Rochester.
All right, we have a very intent World Wrestling Federation fan watching this match. What do you think of this big guy in the ring, Len, the earthquake?
I don't like the earthquake at all for what he did to the Hulkster. There was no reason for that at all, Gene. Just completely attacked him from behind. Uncalled for.
I'm going to throw another one at you, Len. I'm very curious. Do you think that Hulk Hogan will come back?
The Hulkster will be back. Hulkamania rules. All the little Hulkamaniacs are behind him. They're eating their vitamins, saying their prayers. He'll be back, Gene.
Well,
just like this shirt says right here.
I think it says it all. I thank you. Gorilla and Bobby Heenan, let's get back to you.
Thank you, Mean Gene. In the meantime, this youngster is getting squashed out there, Mike Perry. In fact, I noticed earlier on in the match, Brain, that Mike is wearing one of the Hulk Rules Get Well bracelets.
You know, it shows you how stupid the man is. Wearing a Hulk Hogan bracelet, wrestling earthquake, the man that finished off Hogan, that's like committing suicide.
It's all over, just like that. Let's go up to Mike and get the official word.
Here's your winner, Earthquake!
Sounds like the foundation's going here.
War Memorial rocking and rolling here in Rochester, New York as the earthquake unloads with another one. That's got to be stopped.
That's what finished off Hogan. There's history right there.
Five of those.
Well, it doesn't matter.
Didn't finish him off either.
Is he wrestling?
No.
He's finished.
Yeah. You're not wrestling.
wrestling either, and I wish you were finished.
Oh, I'm on the air. I'm managing. I'm still here. Still can get in the ring, and my mind sharper than ever was.
Get some referees in there. Get some more officials in there. There's the bracelet we talked about, but in the meantime, this guy's going to have to go to the hospital.
Wait a minute. I think he's going to go without his bracelet.
Oh, yeah. Look at that.
Yeah. Shows you what he thinks.
Hulk Rude's bracelet torn off and now stepped on. Another form of humiliation.
Notice he sweeps the ring with the bracelet, just like he swept the Brother Love segment with Hulk Hogan.
I don't like what I'm seeing here. Let's go back and take a look at some of the action earlier on.
He's just carrying him like he's carrying a bag of groceries.
500 pounds.
Now that would have been enough to beat anybody right there.
That would be enough to beat anybody right there. But Jimmy Hart is going to give a command, and here we go. Watch this. The big earthquake. Look how high he gets in the air, too. Wow. Oh. Well, there goes your dinner. Well, kid, maybe you should have stayed at the car wash.
There goes Mike on the stretcher. Obviously on the way to the hospital.
There's one of those nice-looking Hulk Rules bracelets. Isn't that pretty?
Let's take you right now to the event center.
Bring back.
I guess, ladies and gentlemen, this week, the Macho King, Randy Savage, and sensational Queen Sherry.
He's prettier every week.
Would you give me a break, Frank? Why? Well, can't they just walk out there? Why do they have to be carried out?
Because they're not peons. They're not commoners. That's the king of the World Wrestling Federation. And the queen. Yes, listen, Duke.
Look. You're just upset because you haven't found a way to get a piece of the change from him yet, have you? Look at her.
All that beautiful white lace.
White's not her color.
I like her red. Flaming red.
Yeah, who did her makeup? Helen Keller? Give me a break.
Of course, then again, she looks good in anything.
Clearly, there is little or no love by you for the common people of this world.
Commoners and peasant people, just like what we have in this arena. In Dusty Rhodes, the American dream, can only fantasize what it is like to be the Macho King. Understand the American dream, Dusty Rhodes. Can't touch this. In Sour Sapphire, what do you think of her, sensational Queen Sherry?
Sour Sapphire, as you slay in that silly little common bed of yours every night, and as you fantasize and you dream about the day that you can have just a little taste of royalty, then you humiliate yourself, Sapphire, when you throw yourself at the Macho King's feet and lay your common lips on his boots. What did it feel like, King, to have that common woman throwing herself at you?
It was better for Sour Sapphire than it was for the Macho King, but she degraded herself in such a way that it gave me a heavenly thrill. But the fantasies of the American dream, Dusty Rhodes, are obvious when we look into your eyes, because you, Dusty Rhodes, the American dream, want to do the same thing as Sour Sapphire, but you want to kiss the feet of the sensational queen. Ooh, yeah.
You know, you talk about the crown jewel of the common people, Sweet Sapphire. Here's another name that rings the bell. Miss Elizabeth.
The love that seems to be for Miss Elizabeth is purely superficial from the commoners. But the love that seems to be for Miss Elizabeth does not come from the sensational queen or the Macho King. But there is love. Yes, Miss Elizabeth, there is love. But it comes not from the Macho King and not from Sensational Queen, but it comes from Brother Love. And Brother Love, yes, Brother Love, accepts your fantasies too, Miss Elizabeth, because you, Miss Elizabeth, on your own accord, going to bend down and kiss the feet of Brother because we are royalty. Oh, yeah.
Never in a million years will you ever see that, Brain.
Hey, if the Macho King says it's going to happen, pal, it's going to happen.
I want to thank each and every one of you guys that wrote letters to the Hulkster, letting them know how you feel about them. I feel so proud. My chest is stuck out so far. You know, just seeing the big guy with a smile on his face after he reads those letters. I mean, there's mounds of them. I mean, he's in the gym pumping iron, taking his vitamins, saying his prayers. The guy that I've always known, he's coming back. And it's all because of you guys. I mean, here's an example. I asked the Hulkster, I says, hey, can I read one of those letters just to the guys and let them know what's going on? He said, yeah. And I got a letter here from 10-year-old Colin Hanger from California. It says, dear Hulk, I have my Hulk Hogan friendship bracelet on right now, and I'm going to keep it on until you come back. Please, Hulk, I love you. I care. And I'm taking my Hulk Hogan vitamins every day, so when you come back and face the earthquake, I'll be there for you, just like you've always been there for me. This is your friend, Colin Hamer. So you see, guys, it don't matter if you're a little itty-bitty Hulkamaniac or a great big Hulkamaniac like me. We're all on the same team. So come on, keep those cards and letters coming, and let's charge.
Well, boss man, I've already proved to the entire world what a complete and total idiot you were at school, a complete and total dunce. And well, boss man, here I am on the very football field where you supposedly played ball. And look who's here standing with me, your old high school football coach, Coach Patton. Now tell me, Coach Patton, did the big boss man play football here?
Well, Mr. DiBiase, if you want to call it that, he was on the team.
He was on the team. Well, let me ask you this thing. You know, football's a game of a great deal of coordination. You got to be real fleet of foot. How coordinated was the big boss man?
Coordinated? He couldn't walk and chew chewing gum at the same time. I used to think he had lace on his panties.
Lace on his panties. I like that. Well, tell me this then, Coach. You know, football's a hitting game. You got to be tough. You got to get in there. You got to hit, 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 hit.
You got it.
Right. What kind of hitter was Boss Man?
The Boss Man. He couldn't crack an egg, Mr. DiBiase.
Couldn't crack an egg. Well, if he couldn't crack an egg and he wasn't a hitter, what position did he play? What was he, a guard?
Yeah, he was a guard. He guarded the water bucket and watched the cheerleaders.
You see, boss man, I've proved it one more time. You're a complete and total hick from a hick school in a hick town in a hick county. And you, boss man, just like all the other hicks in this county, have got a price for the million-dollar man.
What is this?
Brothers and sisters, there have been many intercontinental champions, but never a perfect intercontinental champion. So welcome in this past the perfect intercontinental champion, Mr. Perfect.
Brother Love, you are correct when you say the perfect intercontinental champion. But let's not us overlook, and let us not forget, the perfect manager, Bobby the Brain Heenan. That is right, Brother Love. Let me ask you a question, and let's ask all the humanoids a question. If you were going to have a son, a child, and it grew up, would you want it to look like Brutus the Barber Beefcake with ripped height? Would you want him to have a mediocre physique? Would you want him to have ratty-looking, uncombed hair? Or, Brother Love, would you want something like this? Perfect from head to toe. 6'3", 235 pounds of rock-hard agility and muscle. A beautiful bronze tan. Beautiful white teeth. Beautiful baby blue eyes. And what more can I say? Beautiful blonde glowing locks. I ask you, this is perfect.
God, it is.
And as we talk about the beautiful blonde hair of Mr. Perfect, I'm sure that Beefcake and everybody else out there would like
nothing more than to see the beautiful blonde locks fall to the ground by the scissors of Brutus the Barber Beefcake. Well, Beefcake, you're just like everybody else in the World Wrestling Federation. You're missing the whole point, because what the whole point is about is what is around my waist, the Intercontinental Championship belt. And Beefcake, this is what separates me from everybody else in the World Wrestling Federation. I am what champions are made of. I am not only the greatest wrestler of all time, but I am the greatest wrestler of modern times. And Brutus the Barber Beefcake, do you know when you're gonna cut my hair? And do you know when you're gonna wear the Intercontinental belt? Never!
Oh, but look at this.
Can you imagine?
What?
If Brute beats the Warrior, Heenan's got them both then.
Everybody seems to be concerned about the three demolition. They needn't be. It's a new and improved version.
What's this? What is that? Looks like 1, 2, 3. What is going on? There are three members of demolition?
Is this the so-called surprise you alluded to earlier, Jesse?
Well, there you see Axe, there you see Smash, and guess who the third one is?
I have no idea. What do you know about it?
Crush. Crush, Axe, Smash, and Crush.
Uh-huh.
There's three demolition.
Well, would Crush be considered part of the championship team?
Your guess is as good as mine. Better get a tummy ruling.
You can bet that the Hearts are going to sort it out, and that is Crush. And there with the elbow.
Wham, and did you see that?
Right into the cover, and the creak out.
Axe gave him the signal.
You're going to pay for it.
An opportunity knocks, I kick a stinking door in.
And when the door's knocked out, and we're standing in the doorway, there's no force that can take care of us.
You know, Anvil, no matter how you figure it, you just can't seem to figure it. 2 against 3. I don't understand it. I understand that tag team is 2 against 2. I'd like to ask Jack Tunney what the legal ramifications are of this one.
I can't figure out the legal ramifications, Hitman. I always thought it was two men against two men. What did 3 have to do with it? No, I'm not going to take it. I'm not going to take it.
You have to agree. I think that it's unfair that there are now three members of Demolition. I mean, they must be running scared as it relates to a tag team title defense with the Hearts.
I don't know if that's it or if they're all thinking themselves. Obviously, though, there's going to have to be some type of ruling by President Jack Tunney. I mean, I have to agree with the Hearts. You know, when you're tag champs, that's 2, not 3. And I don't believe an interchange of 2 or 3.
Wow.
Here he is, McMahon.
Yeah, I know.
Without a doubt, probably the most famous man in all of wrestling history.
Yes, he's the only man to have ever knocked Hulk Hogan out of action. He may have not even...
No. Well, out of wrestling, not out of action. He ended his career.
Possibly.
Dream on.
Well, I can tell you I'm still wearing my Hulk Hogan bracelet.
You still will be 3 years from now. What are you going to say to me when 3 years from now I go, hey, McMahon, isn't that bracelet kind of smelly and dirty?
Well, I think there is some limitation, Jesse, but I don't know.
There's no limitation to this man.
Perhaps not. Drop kick in the earthquake, hardly move. Oh, my, now he's moving.
He used that drop kick for momentum.
Yeah. Double bicep, much like Hulk Hogan did. Wait a minute. Hacksaw Jim Duggan. That 2x4 is looking better than ever.
You better believe it. Just like all the fans in the WWF, we're wearing our Hulk Rules bracelets. An earthquake, it's just a matter of time before we chop you down. Tough guy. Ho!
What about that, Jesse?
It remains to be seen.
Well, if anyone can chop the earthquake down, it would be Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Maybe with a 2x4, but he wouldn't do it with his bare hands.
Oh, Cerrone!
Guaranteed.
And down!
And that might be Jim Duggan right there.
What was that on the Richter scale, Jesse?
I got that one. That was a little lighter this week. Only 6.8.
6.8?
Earthquake.
Earthquake sweating all over.
But you know, after one... Wait a minute. After one earthquake, one tremor...
Oh.
What's
he doing?
Take a look at that.
Now, you got to be kidding me. This idiot, Mark Thomas, got into the ring with the earthquake wearing a Hulk Hogan bracelet?
Yeah, earthquake's having a big laugh. Oh, come on, stomping on the bracelet. What's he trying to do? I mean, for a man... Wait a minute! I saw Jim Duggan!